Hey fam.
Hey fam bam.
Welcome back to our channel.
Welcome back. We're going to go straight into this topic because you guys have been asking.
Yeah, you guys have asked us on our DM and on one of our YouTube videos as to how did we deal with long distance
in our relationship. Yeah. Sure. Yeah, it was a journey.
So take us
through that. It wasn't actually easy. Before we jump in, guys, if you haven't already, please do subscribe to our channel and join this fam bam. But yeah, let's get straight into this. It was tough, fam bam. That's one thing I can tell you. And I know a lot of you are facing it because of this lockdown.
Yes.
And you guys have been missing Bay.
I can imagine the stress.
Can you remember?
Like, I know as well, you know, there's a lot of people also that are engaged to be married. And
yeah,
we were actually reflecting on that if we did not get married last year, we would be so frustrated because we wouldn't be able to spend time with each other. So we understand that there's a bit of long distance relationship happening right now because of this pandemic.
Yeah, indeed. And so we just thought, you know what, let's just give you a bit of a testimony history of how we handle things. But it's nothing new. It's nothing out of this world. It's not groundbreaking. It's very basic.
It's basically how we dealt with it.
Yeah.
If we've dealt with it. We even dealt with it.
I think we did. As cliche as this may sound, but we just maintained the communication. I think that's the biggest thing you can ever do.
But do you think that the communication was actually solid?
I think it wasn't solid, but it was somewhat efficient to an extent.
Mm.
But I think beyond communication, and by communication, of course, we're meaning texting each other and calling each other. I know
Skype
was a thing, at that time, because there wasn't this WhatsApp videos and stuff like that at the time.
Mm.
So I think we managed, we handled it that way. Mm-hmm. But I don't think it was sufficient because in spite of just texting and seeing you on a screen, babe, I wanted to hold you. And I think we mentioned this, I don't know, in the cheating video that we had, Did You Cheat On Me? I'll just link it up here. That was one of the reasons why I chose to cheat on my girlfriend, Rehumuditswe, at that time.
Mm.
It's because of that. It's because I personally just couldn't handle it just texting. Mm-hmm. It was sweet and all.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, babe, we used to, like I said, we used to go out a lot.
Mm-hmm.
We used to hang out a lot.
Mm-hmm.
And just your physical presence was missing.
I think you missed, like you said, you missed me being around.
That's right.
And, but that's the thing. You get into this type of relationship knowing that, okay, there'll be a time when we'll be separated for a while.
Yeah.
Do you understand?
Yeah.
So we have to implement things and we have to sit down and discuss, okay, what are we going to do to make this relationship work? Guys, remember that a relationship is work. It's not just, we're in a relationship, I just have a boyfriend.
Yeah, things won't just fall into place.
Yeah, and then we'll be hunky-dory, we'll fall in love. Of course, you know, when you're away, you miss the person, you become so emotional.
Exactly.
You just want to hug them and kiss them, and that's it. And it's hard. It was hard, definitely. Even on my side, I mean, like, it was far away and all I had was a screen to see you.
Exactly.
And time schedules as to, okay, I can only call you from this time to this time.
Yeah.
So it was a bit hard in that sense.
You actually bring up something else as well. Data.
Yeah.
Data.
There was Wi-Fi.
You know how people data.
No, there was Wi-Fi. There was Wi-Fi.
You had Wi-Fi back then.
I had AfriHost. Yeah.
AfriHost. Yeah, I remember. Yeah, I remember.
AfriHost that time.
Yeah.
I literally had to buy data.
Yeah.
Well, that Wi-Fi data and make sure. And at that time, you're a student.
Mm.
You know, you don't have the money to be buying 500 megabytes of data.
Yeah,
or
50 true. And that doesn't last. We all know that.
Yeah, it doesn't last.
It does not.
No.
So, but did that work for you personally? Like, be
totally
honest,
To be honest, I think you're my first like serious relationship.
Yeah.
And, obviously it was still the early stages, so it wasn't like I said, we liked each other. Being in a long distance relationship actually helped us to realize that actually this person is the person that you want to be with for the rest of your life. So I think when you are far apart from from each other, just your heart grows fonder,
yeah,
right?
Yeah.
And you're like, but no, this one is the right person
yeah.
for me. Even yeah. though you see a thousand other guys, you,
yeah.
see, you realize that, oh no, I actually am in that state of falling in love again and again, even though we are far apart from each other.
Okay, cool. Mm-hmm. Well said, I must say. Well done. But I'm going to put you on the spot. You still cheated on me.
Yes. And?
And so why? Like, if you knew, Jorge,
yeah.
it's a long distance.
Yeah.
I am the one.
Yeah.
At least you thought I was.
Yes.
And indeed.
Like I said.
But why then did you still choose
yeah.
to cheat? Because you chose.
Correct. It is a choice at
yeah.
the end of the day.
Yeah.
And you chose because of feelings.
No, not don't say you chose.
Well, I chose.
Yes. Personalize this thing.
Alrighty.
You gotta own it.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right. I own it, of
yeah.
course.
Okay.
And because I know it's finished.
Yeah.
But anyway,
mm.
In that state, it's a matter of, like you said, in the beginning,
yeah.
we weren't serious.
Yeah.
You understand?
And
we
that's
were
the
still
thing, Bam,
trying
yeah.
to get to know each other.
Like any other relationship.
And,
yeah.
Yes. And it. Like when people say it's not what not official, it's official but not official.
Yeah, that kind
it's
of
it's weird
thing.
When people say that. I know.
Super, super weird.
Yeah.
yeah.
But yes, at that time it was official but not official, and we still weren't honest with each other. I mean, like we never really told
yeah.
each other our deepest, darkest secrets.
There yeah.
were still secrets that we still didn't tell each other.
True.
You know, we won't like open.
Okay.
I was just, hi, babe, how are you? Oh,
mm-hmm.
no, I'm good. Oh, no, I'm flying
mm-hmm.
today. I'm doing this.
What
doing
did you
this.
Do today?
Yeah.
Blah, blah, blah.
Mm-hmm. There was like, and then maybe there were times where it was like, okay, but like, and then we still had arguments over
Skype, yeah,
over Skype,
yeah. That why did you not
yeah.
Skype me
at
this time?
This
you said
time,
at this
you
time
said
it's
at
our
this
Skype date.
Mm.
What's going on?
Yeah, you get upset. You find a reason to get upset.
Yeah.
Any reason,
mm-hmm.
just to be like, ah, this guy,
whatever.
Antenna.
Yeah.
Mm.
But still, you haven't answered the question.
Mm.
Why did you choose?
Like I said.
To still cheat on me, yeah.
No, like I said, at that time we weren't serious. So therefore, it wasn't a matter of, I didn't know that I was
mm.
hurting you.
Mm.
I didn't know. It was just being selfish.
So in other words, were you missing me? I just want to know that part because...
I was missing you, but you weren't there.
Yeah.
So therefore...
You found a replacement
exactly.
to kind of
mm-hmm.
fill up that void.
Yeah.
And exactly what you, Femba, might be facing right now under this lockdown restrictions,
mm-hmm.
wherever you may be.
Don't,
Hmm?
Don't
no,
go away.
No.
Tell me, now I'm putting
what?
You on the spot. Okay, well, now, why did you choose to cheat on me?
I chose for this exact same reason. I mean, like I said, I wanted Rego's physical presence. I wanted you to be with me. It wasn't just about the lovely texts, the smiley emojis and all these
mm-hmm.
love emojis and beautiful words
enough.
That you could say. It's not enough. It wasn't enough. And then at least the Skype face-to-face on a screen was as close enough as it was to reality. But still, the physical touch, your scent, your smell, your just everything about you I wanted, right? But I didn't get. And unfortunately, yes, I was surrounded by people who were interested in me. And yeah, because I kind of entertained them and... Yeah, I gave in to temptation.
Okay.
And I chose to cheat on you. And
okay.
of course, we...
So what lesson have you learned from that? That you would advise your younger self to avoid that and to still maintain a good, healthy, long-distance relationship?
I couldn't... There's no specific... how can I say... lesson that I can give my younger self because I had to go through that.
You had
I would,
to.
In other words, I wouldn't have known better had I went through that. However, with that said, I'm not saying, I'm not condoning it.
Though. Yeah, I
I'm
was
not
about
saying,
to say.
Yeah, I'm not condoning. I'm not saying, yeah, okay, guys, everybody, if you're in a long-distance relationship, just cheat on your partner and you realize that it is actually the one or she's actually the one.
Okay.
I'm not condoning it. But if I was to tell myself or give myself a little pep talk, my younger self, I would say, young man, listen, it's not worth it, obviously. It's going to hurt you. It's going to hurt her as well, right?
So what would be the solution?
The solution for me would have been that we either take a break. No, here's the solution.
But that's the thing.
No, no, no.
I think we did try to do that.
We
did we
tried,
try,
but we didn't.
We tried to say, okay, we want to take a break. But you were like,
okay,
if we
I think
a
I
break,
have an answer. I think I have an
if
answer.
If we take a break, Dise was going to break up with me forever. And,
yeah, and that's
like,
what you were afraid of.
And I was like, no, but I can't
this
break
woman
up with
fan
you
wouldn't let me go. I was like, babe, maybe we should take time out. And that's my solution. I would maybe say, okay.
No, I was the one who suggested time out. And you were like,
yeah,
no,
you did,
we
you
don't
did.
Do
I don't
time
do time out. We either break up or
we break up and then we die.
But
I would have lost.
I'm going
I would have lost.
I'm not baby. You'd never lose me.
Oh
never
my
lose
word.
Me. Don't cry. Are you seriously crying?
No, they didn't. Leave me
alone. Oh my goodness. Don't cry.
No, seriously.
God, you're going to make me cry.
Okay, wait.
Hey.
I did not expect that.
Oh, man.
Okay, guys, let's take 2 seconds. Tisa, please forgive me tissue.
Oh, goodness. Okay, wait. Ish. Okay, wait.
I did not expect that.
Don't cry. She mustn't do this. I can't get the tissue now. It's going to be a long mission. So you're going to just have to survive with your tears.
Okay, just but
I think I would definitely tell my younger self that, you know what, try out the timeout maybe, but don't break up. I don't think breaking up is going to solve anything, because for me, it was a unique situation for us.
Okay.
Because our distance was due to your career just starting off, right?
Yes.
And so that was kind of prepping us.
And there was
for
no understanding.
Yeah, and there was no understanding. There was
no textbook, there was
no rehearsals, there was nothing. But this was the rehearsal, because now we're married and we're experiencing exactly the same thing.
Yes.
Where Rego is gone for a certain amount of days at times when she has to fly out. And I'm left at home alone.
Yeah.
For now, until I'll be, you know, I'll have my company, you know, when the little ones come. But for now, I'm alone. For now, I'm alone. Yeah, I'll have my company. But for now, I'm alone. So it kind of prepped us so that we can get used to the fact that you'll be away.
Okay, I've got a better answer to that. I think what it has done is that it has prepped us in the sense of we value our relationship more than we did in the past. It was, we were young-minded.
Yeah.
Not mature enough. Mm. Not taking each other seriously.
Sorry, your eyeliner, you know, is running.
Is it?
Yeah.
Okay, sorry. So yeah, we weren't taking each other serious. So now that I still travel, you see, also you have to understand, is this long distance a short-term thing, or is long distance a long-term thing? For us, it's still a long-term thing because we're still dealing with it even now.
Yeah.
Whereby, but now it's different. Yes, I'm away for a week. The maximum that I can be away is for a week.
Yeah.
But then the minimum is like obviously a day or two. But then at that time it was for like
months.
2 months and then I could come back home. So there's a difference because of it's now still a long, maybe for people, it could be just 2 years maybe. They're living maybe in
Cape another,
Town.
Or not even another country.
Or even another country.
Yeah, maybe you're teaching in China somewhere in Asia or Europe.
Yes.
And you're away that long. Yeah.
And that long.
Yeah.
So
deciding
whether you want a long distance relationship you have to understand, okay, how long are we gonna deal with this?
Okay.
Do you understand?
I get you now.
Mm. How long are we gonna do the Skype thing?
Mm.
Non-touch thing. You're gonna surprise me only once in a blue moon to buy a plane ticket. Plane tickets are gonna be expensive now. They're not gonna be that cheap.
Indeed.
So you have to understand that it's a hard decision to make whether you break up or take a break or not.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and there's people that make it apparent in the beginning, we'll have an open relationship. You know, do you want to deal with all that? Is it a safer option to say, we'll be in an open relationship but they obviously there'll be T's and C's. Things mustn't happen.
Those T's and C's don't apply. You know how it is.
Then it's a breakup. It then rather just break
it's
up.
It's almost like a breakup.
Then rather just, break up so that we don't, no strings attached, nothing happens.
No.
You're
right.
Yeah.
You're right, my love. I think you hit the head of the nail right there. If you're in this predicament of distance in your relationship due to this lockdown, what do you suggest, babe? People need advice.
Okay, so the one quote that I've seen recently was that distance doesn't separate people.
Silence does.
Exactly.
It's when you're quiet and when there's no communication that's where there's a drift that's happening, right?
Yeah.
So now how do we merge it?
Honesty.
And bring it closer?
Honesty.
Yeah.
Being honest with each other.
But how? Like, is that practical? I'm thinking about practical things.
Like I said, in the beginning, we were not honest with each other with regards to exactly the way that I'm feeding. It's like it's like that whole thing of when I call somebody and then I'm like, how are you? And the person's like, oh, no, I'm fine. Kanti, deep down, they have real issues. Mm. So that's why it's important to be honest with the people that you say you love and just tell them that, you know what, babe, this is very hard for me.
Mm.
I can't do this anymore, but I'm trying my best.
But then it's tough now because of lockdown. Like, it's easy to say that and say, I can't handle it. But what's the solution? Like, what's the alternative? It's, what? Are you saying that people should be single then?
No, no. I said to be honest and to communicate.
Okay, so that's a step in the right direction.
The silence is what kills the relationship. Okay. If you're not honest with each other,
so be open.
If you're not talking to each other, be honest, be open, talk it out.
Okay, so let's
make a plan.
Yeah, let's make a plan.
Let's
try make a plan. Let's role play here. So this is me saying, okay, babe, listen, this thing is killing me. I haven't seen you since March, April. When? February, March.
Mm.
It's killing me.
Mm.
And you say to me, same thing.
Yeah.
Okay, so what do we do? We've been Skyping, we've been WhatsApp video chats and so forth and so on. There's Zoom now, we're even on Zoom together.
Can we survive this?
Can we survive this?
Is this worthy?
Mm. Is this worth it?
Is it worth it?
Yeah.
You know, where is our future in this
life,
in this relationship?
Am I still the one?
Mm. It's tough.
Are you going to still take out Lobola one day? Hey, yeah, but you know what, Fam Bam, we don't know all the answers. We don't have all the answers.
Correct.
But we just suggest exactly what you mentioned, my love, that be honest, speak about it, be open about it.
Mm.
But even for yourself, think about your own relationship with your partner right now. How serious is it? Is this the one for you?
Mm.
Do you really, really realistically see a future?
Mm.
And if so, then yeah, you're going to stick it through, you know?
You're going to stick it through. Remember, a relationship has ups and downs.
Yeah.
So you have to stick it through it all.
And I think... we're just a testimony of that. For 9 years, we've had to deal with long distance in a way. So we've survived it and are surviving it.
Yes.
And
you see, we're still in it.
And it's worked for us and we love it. And like we said, the distance works because you miss her. And when she comes back, it's like, oh, lovey-dovey again and everything. Mm-hmm. And it's great. You know, time out as well. You know, spend time on your own and do your own thing. But the love is still there because we're forever communicating.
Exactly.
So, yeah.
For now, you can't even do anything because
now I'm locked down with her.
God is in between. Yeah. So, and if you hurt me, you're hurting God.
I'm hurting God.
Exactly.
So, don't point at me and you. And you don't do anything silly.
I know. Okay. Yeah. You're my baby for life.
Thank you, my love. Mm. Well, Nana.
So, yes, guys.
She's satisfied. Don't worry, Fembe.
Anyway. This guy. But guys, I hope you guys can work it out with your partner.
Mm-hmm.
I hope you guys can keep strong and just love each other throughout the long distance. Communicate, talk about your feelings, be honest.
Yeah.
If you feel like you're gaining feelings for somebody else,
be honest. Why? How are you gaining? And it's sad because you might be gaining feelings through virtual interactions. You understand? Mm. Now you're starting to chat with your ex and...
Infatuations.
But remember what you have and hold on to what you have because... that is solid and you can't let that go. You can't let all that time that you spent with this partner of yours go to waste.
Yeah.
You know, see this as that training ground, that trial, you know. But yeah, you'll get through this. But above everything, in prayer, bring your relationship to God.
Amen.
And let Him intervene.
Correct. Mm. Yeah, I can't top that. That is the ultimate, penultimate.
Yep.
But yes, guys, thank you so much for joining us on this very interesting LDR video.
Yeah, and hey, if you have solutions for the other fam bams, please hit us up on the comment section. Tell us and tell everybody, tell the whole fam bam what they could be doing during this lockdown where you haven't seen your partner for a couple of weeks and months now.
Yeah.
What solutions?
How did you deal with the LDR?
Or how are you dealing with it?
Yeah, currently.
Currently, yeah. Because we're fortunate. Now we're in one roof. Yeah.
Okay.
Anyway, so if you have not already subscribed, please do subscribe and join the fam bam. And we'll catch you on the next video or vlog. But until then,
adios, fam bam.
Bye.